welcome here to the House of Pianos for the first episode of Gems of Arabia. Myself, I'm a singer and an actor and presenter. Very excited to start this first episode and invite talents from the UAE and international to share their inspirational stories and showcase also their talents. Let's start now. I have a very special guest here today, which is Alex Broun from Australia, writer, director, UAE based. Alex, how are you? Long time we didn't see each other.
That's right, Vim. It's very, very nice to be here and very nice to be at the House of Pianos. It's a beautiful location.
We have already such a nice experience together. I remember you are active in so many fields, but you're most famously remembered for Neighbours, I think.
Yeah, well, it's really interesting because I actually started my acting career a long, long time ago on Neighbours. This is tell everybody how old I am, but I started off with Kylie Minogue acting on Neighbours over, gosh, you know, it's over 30 years ago. And of course, there's the very sad news this week has just come out that Neighbours is probably no longer continuing. Channel 5 in the UK have decided not to continue it, and it looks like it's shutting down. And Barry Crocker, who sung the theme song, the Neighbours theme song, which is very famous, because there's a bit of Neighbours nostalgia now, that's actually gone to number one in the UK. So everybody's thinking back to Neighbours and the time when Kylie was on, Kylie Minogue was on and Jason Donovan on that. And that's when I was on, way, way, way back then, over 30 years ago. So it's, yeah, it was a wonderful experience at the time. And I was probably a bit young and a bit stupid and I thought I was a bigger star than I was. So I wasn't on Neighbours for that long, but it was great to be on such an iconic show so early in my career.
You became very famous with your short plays. And when you decided to come to Dubai about 10 years ago, I think, what was the story about Short and Sweet?
Well, what happened for me was I was quite successful. I was acting in Neighbours. I acted at Home and Away, which is another very famous Australian show.
Kidman.
I did some movies with Nicole Kidman. I did some youth theatre plays with Nicole Kidman. So I was very lucky to work with Nicole early in her career. For me, I just got a little bit disillusioned with acting. I found that I wasn't so comfortable in front of the camera. I was comfortable, but I was more comfortable behind the camera, and I was more interested in writing and directing. I wasn't actually that interested in being in front of the camera. So I sort of began to focus more on writing and focus more on directing. And I lived in South Africa for 5 years, from 95 to 2000, and I came back to Australia. And I was just kind of looking about getting back into the theatre scene when I returned to Australia. And they had Short and Sweet had only just started. It just started in Sydney. And I thought, wow, 10-minute plays, that's a great idea. And I'd actually already started writing 10-minute plays before I'd heard about Short and Sweet. But I said, oh, well, I've got some plays. Hey, how about we put these on? And I met Mark Cleary back in about, I think, 2001 or so, around about the time of the first Short and Sweet. And Mark sort of directed one of my plays in the very first Short and Sweet. So that's how I sort of got involved with 10-minute plays, and I've been fascinated by it ever since. And then coming to Dubai, that's what brought me to Dubai, essentially. I came here around a decade ago because I was in Bangalore in India running a theatre festival there, and I just wanted to have a bit of a holiday, so I came to Dubai. I met some of the local theatre community here, and they thought it'd be a great idea to start up Short and Sweet here. So I began Short and Sweet here 10 years ago, and now Short and Sweet Dubai is almost the largest Short and Sweet festival in the world. It's been running for over a decade. And they do over 100 plays. And it's right across the road from the House of Piano in Al Circle Avenue at the junction. It's right across there in Al Cos. So,
you have quite a huge number of plays. I understood that you have a record of that.
Yeah, listen, I believe I hold the record. I've written over 120 different 10-minute plays.
Wow.
And I've had over 100 plays produced in over 4,000 productions.
Wow.
So there's certainly other writers who have more productions of 10-minute plays, such as David Ives, but I believe that I've written the most 10-minute plays to be produced because I've written over 100. So I believe, you know, maybe I need to contact the Guinness Book of Records and see if they have an office here in Dubai, so I should maybe go down there and see if I can get into the Guinness Book of Records.
Your story, your inspiration, what advice would you give for people who have an ambition in the theatre or in the writing or whatever? You give also acting classes, I know.
Listen, I think Dubai is a fantastic place, and I'm not just saying that because I'm sitting here in the House of Piano talking to you about Dubai. It is a fantastic place. It's an amazing place. I've been here 10 years. If I could choose to be anywhere in the world, maybe it might be New York, maybe it might be London, maybe it might be Los Angeles, but you know, Dubai would be very, very high up on that list, and I think it's a fantastic place to live. I think there's lots of wonderful people here doing lots of amazing things, such as yourself, Vim, you know? And also, I mean, Expo has been such an amazing event. I mean, I saw you singing there the other day at the Belgian Pavilion. You know, it's been such an amazing, a lot of the focus has been drawn towards Expo. So it'll be very interesting to see, perhaps, you know, after Expo happened, what happens in the performing arts, how that spreads out through the society.
About a nice project we did together. We started that about 3 years ago before the COVID. It was called Don't You Forget About Me. Mm. And you helped me so much with that.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, listen, it was a great project to work on, Vim. It was a very interesting project because it was like an interactive film on stage where you were interacting, of course, on stage with a character played by Susie Dimitrios who was on the screen. And it was a very, very interesting exercise to do in a very interesting format. So it's wonderful to see that you're still doing that all these years later and it's still been very successful.
We have done about 5 shows
now. Fantastic.
In the UAE, and we changed the name, Love Beyond the Sea.
Oh, that's lovely.
It's still the same movie, but we changed a little bit the songs.
Well, it's all set on the cruise liner, isn't it?
Yes,
so it works perfectly.
It's Love Beyond the Sea. Yes, I did at the QE2, Love Beyond the Sea, which was really matching there. And definitely we will work more on that and hopefully we make it, bring it internationally, bring the show in Belgium.
I think fantastic because I think it's a story, it's a love story of course, and it's a love story about a man who falls in love with a woman on a billboard and the woman on the billboard comes to life. So there's this wonderful interaction between, you know, the dream character and the real character and he sort of finds something in the dream and she finds something in him. But the big problem is of course, she's on a billboard, he's in real life, how do they, you know, get together. So I think it's very, you know, it's a very, very interesting and unique idea. And of course, you sing so many wonderful songs in it too. There's some fantastic songs which you sing beautifully.
Thank you, Alex. Well, we chose those songs together, I remember. And now for today, for this interview, you have chosen 2 songs. Can you talk about it?
Yeah, well, one of the songs is The Music of the Night. Now, I think for the theatre and being in the theatre, of course, Phantom of the Opera is one of the most successful operas of all time. I mean, I might have chosen something from Hamilton or from Les Miserables, but I went with the Music of the Night. And it's a beautiful, beautiful song. And I have a real sort of empathy, a real understanding of the character of the Phantom. You know, he's a man who loves the theatre, who loves the theatre. He lives in a theatre, he breathes the theatre, he loves the theatre. But it's always just eluded him, that magic, he's just missing out on that magic and he thinks he's found it in the young opera singer, of course, which ends you know, the way it does in the musical. If you don't know what happens in Phantom of the Opera, you've got to watch it. But it's a beautiful, beautiful song. It's one of the most famous songs. And also it's a song you sing so beautifully, Vim. So I thought it was a really, really nice choice.
Thank you.
And the second song, To Dream the Impossible Dream. I mean, what an absolute classic, you know, The Man from La Mancha, what a classic. And I think that it defines very much the dream or the mission that we're all on here in the UAE in the performing arts, because we would love to see the performing arts elevated to, we would love to see UAE stories, we would love to see, I mean, Just Like That is a contemporary play that's been done here recently, but I just love to see the performing arts grow here more, both with expats and Emiratis as well. And I just think there's such rich, fertile soil there. And it is, at this moment, it remains a bit of an impossible dream. But I think it's a beautiful, beautiful song. And I think it's a song that represents so many things to so many people. And again, another good choice. And again, you sing it so well.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to right the unrightable wrong, to love so pure and chase from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right, without question or cause, to be willing to march and to help for a heavenly cause. And I know if I only be true to this glorious quest, be peaceful and calm when I lay to my rest.
So happy that you came on the show, Gems of Arabia, by myself, Wim Hoste, here at the House of Pianos. It was fantastic to have you here.
Thank you, Wim. It's been wonderful to be here at the House of Pianos and to speak to you and to speak about the performing arts in the UAE and the future of it. Let's hope for that our impossible dreams come true.
Yes.